I'm with Billy Alexandre in the Thinkware booth. What do you guys have for us today?
For you guys today, we have dash cams. So dash cams are specialized onboard surveillance devices. So they are cameras that you just attach on the windshield and then plug it into the power outlet, turn on the car and go. You don't have to do anything else. So the purpose of having a dash cam in your car is a third eyewitness. So a third eyewitness, if you happen to be in an accident and you want to back up your claim, you don't have to go looking for witnesses. You have it stored in the device.
Now, people in Russia love these, right? They're all over Russia and they got that meteor coming in and everything, right?
You're right, yeah. So it's really big in Russia and Korea. Actually, it's so big in Korea right now that insurance companies recognize this as being reliable products, and people do get discounts on the insurances as well.
Wow, so it looks like you have a lot of different models here?
Yeah, so we have four new models for the year of 2015. The F750 has received an award from the CES show for best design and best engineering. So it does everything it's supposed to do and even better. So it's a very simple design. You put it behind the windshield and it conceals nicely.
Oh, so it's actually inside the car, inside
the
dash?
Inside the car, yeah. That's why it's called a dash cam. And inside the car, mounted on a windshield. So
I don't know why I thought it would be outside. That's just
dumb. It's okay. Some people think that way as well.
So tell me, why is this better than having a GoPro mounted inside your car?
Oh, excellent question. GoPro is an action cam. So it's actually designed to be outside and to withstand a lot of like extreme conditions. But the thing that GoPro can do that a dash cam does is it doesn't have the auto-looping function, meaning that when you keep filming on a GoPro, eventually it runs out of space and you can't record anything else. So on the dash cam, it has the auto-looping section, so it overwrites the old files, and so it keeps recording and recording. So it's specialized for a vehicle.
I guess that makes sense. So right after you've just been in a head-on collision, do you have to remember to stop it so it doesn't ride over?
That's also something that we address by having different folder systems, meaning that when the dash cam records something, it will store it in different folders. For example, if you get into a crash or an accident, it has G-sensor, so it will sense the impact. So G-sensors meaning that a certain speed changes or an impact or sudden stop, it will sense it, record it, and put it in a different folder so then you can retrieve it easily afterwards.
Wow, that is really cool. So what price point are you going for on these?
Price point, those will be available in the US around March. This one, the F750, will be $299.
That sounds just about right. This looks really cool. Thank you very much, Billy.
Thank you very much.